If you use Microsoft 365 or Office 2021 and up, the RAND array function makes generating random datasets in Excel a whole lot easier. So RAND array is a dynamic function that combines features from both the RAND and RANDBETWEEN functions, then adds even more tricks. So the full RAND array function has arguments where you can set how many rows and columns should be included in your results. You can set the minimum and maximum values, and you can even set whether you want them formatted as decimals or as integers. And depending on what results you're looking for, you may or may not need to use all or really any of these at times. So let's say we want to generate a single random number in a cell like we would have with the RAND function. Using RAND array, we would simply type equals RAND array, open and close the parentheses, and press enter to generate a random number between 0 and 1. You can also set the quantity of random numbers generated by using the inputs for the number of rows and columns that you want the results to be in. And this is using the first two arguments of the function. So let's look at a few examples. So let's say we want to apply random numbers to the 10 rows below the cell in which we're typing the function. So we would type equals rand array, open your parentheses, type the number 10, close the parentheses, and press enter. And we can do this with only the number 10 by itself because rows is the first argument in the function. Now, let's say we wanted to insert random values into only the 5 columns to the right of the active cell. Well, in this case, we would need to use a comma to skip over the first argument and type the number 5 for the second argument. So it would look like equals rand array, comma, because we want to skip the rows argument, type the number 5 for the number of columns, close the parentheses, and then press enter. So you can probably guess what the next example is going to be. So to insert random values into an area made up of 10 rows and 5 columns, we would type equals rand array. We'll type 10 in the first argument for the number of rows, 5 columns, close the parentheses, and press enter. Like in RANDBETWEEN, with RAND array, you can set minimum and maximum limits for your random numbers, and you're going to find this option in the third and fourth argument of the function. So, building on our last example, let's say that we want for the random values in our 10 by 5 cell range to be no less than 200 and no more than 750. Our formula would look like equals rand array. We'll type 10 in the first argument for the number of rows, 5 columns, and then for the min, we'll type 200. And 750 for the maximum. Now we close our parentheses, press enter, and we have a set of random numbers within the minimum and maximum limits that we've set. As you could probably tell by our earlier results, the default for this function is decimal values. In the final argument of the RAND array function, you can set whether you'd like for the results to be formatted as decimals or integers. This means that if you want your results to be in decimal form, you can just press enter and skip this argument altogether. But if you want for your random values to be formatted as integers, you'll need to select that in the final argument. And you can do that either by typing true or the number 2 for this argument. So using our example of the 10 by 5 cell range, we'll type 10 for the number of rows, 5 for the columns, a 200 for the minimum value, 750 for the max, and we'll type the number 2. To select integer in the final argument. Thanks for watching. For more tutorials like this, click on these links. Thanks.